Welcome to Janus Tutorial. Today we have come up with a new concept related to tenses. So this is a subject related to English grammar. So many of you might be confused with the English grammar and with the tenses. So in this video I am going to give you a clear explanation regarding the types of tenses with the examples. So please don't forget to subscribe my channel by pressing the bell button and also press the all button so that all my new notifications can reach your mobile immediately. Okay, now let us enter into our topic. Now what is a tense? So tense is nothing but it is a form of verb, we can say. Okay, so in the parts of the speech you have learned the verbs. So tense is nothing but a form of verb which defines an action, okay, which is going to happen or happening or happen. So based on this we are going to divide the tense into three types. Okay, so tense is nothing but it is a form of verb which defines an action which is going to happen or happening or happen. Okay, so based on these actions we are going to divide the tenses into three types. So what are they? Let us see. First one is your present tense and next one is your past tense and third one is future tense. Present tense, past tense and future tense. So tense is divided into three types like this. So in present tense what is going to happen? Present tense is nothing but, so here an action which is happening in the present moment, or you are going to speak the true words of the action. So that indicates a present tense. Okay, the next, past tense. Past tense is nothing but an action which has already happened, means you have completed the action. So that indicates a past tense. Whereas future tense, future tense is nothing but an action which will happen in future. So this is called as the future tense. So here it didn't happen till now, it may happen in the future. Such type of action is called as the future tense. So you will be more clear with the examples, I think so. For example, present tense. So present tense is what? An action which is happening at the present moment of time. So present moment of time is nothing but, for example, I am playing cricket. So this action you are doing it now. Or you can take one more example like I am studying or I am writing or I am reading. So all this can be taken as the examples for present tense. So I am doing now, I am reading, I am studying, I am writing or I am playing cricket. So these all are happening now. Okay, in present it is happening, the action, so I call it as a present tense. The next, past tense, an action which has already happened. So already happened means what? Can you take the example? For example, I went to school. I went to market. these are the examples of past tense. So here you can see went, played, read. Already the action has been completed. I went to school. Already I went to school. Now I am not going to school. Okay, so I completed going to the school, which comes under the past tense. Action has been completed. I went to market. So I went to market to buy the vegetables. Now I am not going. Action is not going now. Already it has been completed. So this comes under the example of a past tense. I played tennis. Already I played the tennis. Now I am not playing the tennis. Okay. So action has been completed. I read a book. So already I completed reading the book. Okay. Did you read the book? Okay. Already I have read the book. So which is nothing but the example of a past tense. And the remaining one is future tense. An action which will happen in future. So till now it didn't happen. We didn't do that action, and we are going to do the action in future is nothing but the example of the future tense. So example, I may go to school tomorrow. I may go to office tomorrow. So here when you see may, okay, may is nothing but I may go. Till now it didn't happen. So I may go tomorrow. So tomorrow is nothing but the next future tense we are going to represent. So this is the example of future tense. Till now it didn't happen and it is going to happen in the future. So these are the examples of present tense, past tense and future tense. This can also be called as simple tense or simple present tense. Okay, so this we are going to divide in the present tense. So you can say it as simple tense or simple present tense under the name of the indefinite tense. And your second one is continuous tense. And third one is perfect tense. And your fourth one is perfect continuous tense. So totally there are four types: indefinite tense or simple present tense, continuous tense, perfect tense and perfect continuous tense. So here you got totally four types of tenses. These four types of tenses are coming from the present tense. So in this way, with the same thing you have been derived in the past tense also, you get totally four types of tenses, and in the future tense also you get totally four types of tenses. So only the name is going to get differed here, as in place of present you are going to get it as past tense. Okay, so like indefinite tense, continuous past tense, perfect tense and perfect continuous past tense. And when you are going to take the future tense, again the same thing is going to happen: simple future tense, continuous future tense, perfect future tense and perfect continuous future tense. So totally four tenses in your present tense, plus four tenses in your past tense, plus four tenses in the future tense. So totally 12 tenses you are going to get on the whole. So there are totally 12 types of tenses. The next I am going to give you the examples for each and every tense. Before writing any sentence, we have to make a sentence subject plus verb plus object in this manner. So first should be your subject, second should be your verb and third one should be your object. So S plus V plus O we say. So subject is nothing but I and verb is go and object is school. So totally I make this as I go to school. This is generally I am giving you the information as how do you write a sentence. Now coming to our topic, to indefinite tense. So here I have given the examples. What is an indefinite tense? Indefinite tense is nothing but which does not have any particular time. Means particular time is not mentioned. Such type of sentence is called as an indefinite tense. So see here the example. I write articles on different topics. Means I don't know when I have started and when I am going to stop. Okay, I write the articles on different topics. Is there any time mentioned that I have started from some time and I am going to end at some time? So there is no particular definite time. Start and end time is not mentioned for you in this. Whereas when you take the second example, he goes to library every day. Okay, so he is going to library every day. So when he starts and when it is going to end, from what time he started going to library and when he stopped going to library, there is no definite time. Start time and end time is not mentioned. So such type of tense is called as an indefinite tense. Now next, when you take the second one, continuous tense. Continuous tense is nothing but which is happening, going or running in the present moment of time. So such type of tense is called as a continuous tense. For example, she is crying. Means now also she is crying. It is going on. The action is going on. Action is continuing. It is going on. She is crying. Then next, he is talking to his friend. Means he is continuing talking with his friend. Now also he is talking. So such kind of actions are called as continuous tense. Okay. The action which is going on. Then next, when you take the third one, perfect tense. So perfect tense is nothing but an action already completed. Such kind of tense is called as a perfect tense. For example, he has finished his homework. Means already he completed doing his work. Okay, so completed doing the work. Such kind of tense is nothing but a perfect tense. It has been completed totally. Next example, we have been to Canada. Means we have shifted to Canada. We already went to Canada. Okay, so this action also has been completed. We went there and we are living there. Okay, so such kind of tense is called as a perfect tense. And the fourth one is perfect continuous tense. So perfect continuous tense is nothing but combination of this. Both you can take as continuous tense and the perfect tense. So here you can see, continuous tense is nothing but the action which is going on. Okay, and you can take here perfect tenses which has been started at some time. Okay, some particular time I'm going to mention over here. So that is the perfect continuous tense. Example, I have been studying for 3 hours. Okay, so still the action is going on, studying. I am studying. So from what time you have started studying? Before 3 hours you have started studying. Okay, so from 3 hours you are continuing studying, which is nothing but the perfect continuous tense. One more example you can see. I have been watching TV since 7 p.m. Okay, for example, now if the time is 10 o'clock, so from what time are you watching the TV? So I am watching means you are continuing till now. Continuous function. From 7 p.m. I have a definite time which I am mentioning, which is nothing but a perfect continuous tense. So remaining tenses, by this we have completed 4 tenses, and remaining tenses we are going to look at in the next session. So if you have liked my video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel to watch my upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.